Hello guys, this is your guy Rajat. So I hope all of you are doing really well in your lives. So in my last video, I asked you to leave comments regarding what type of videos you would like to see on my channel. So Ali asked me to release videos about React Native, Firebase and GraphQL, etc. So in today's video, we are going to learn about Firebase real-time database. Now, in today's video, I'm going to tell you what Firebase real-time database is, how it is a NoSQL database. So we are going to learn about this new thing, NoSQL database, and how it can actually help you in architecting your application. Also, in case you are interested in learning more about such stuff, make sure to subscribe to Rain Studio's YouTube channel. And in case you want me to create videos about topics you are interested in, make sure to leave a comment on this video or any other video you consume on this channel. Also, make sure to follow me on Instagram because I am going to release several bite-sized tech-related videos on Instagram TV, which I think can benefit you in making you more productive as far as software development is concerned. So let's suppose you are trying to create a social network. So in that social network, people can interact with each other. Now, if you are going down a conventional route, you first have to establish a database. Then you have to write some sort of REST APIs which can take the data out of that database and provide it to the user. So now you'll have to design some REST API and then you have to pick a programming language to write this REST API in. Then you also have to concern yourself with writing systems like authentication system, reporting system and all, right? So this is an added complexity which is going to reside at your backend. Now with Firebase, we can use components like Firebase real-time database management system and Firebase authentication to really shortcut the entire backend infrastructure. So we really don't have to code all of this stuff. We can pick and choose the things from Firebase ecosystem, and then Firebase is going to manage all of the infrastructure for you. So you don't really have to be concerned with the updates of the software stack and how the data is going to be returned to your application. You don't really have to squash bugs from your REST API. So this is going to take this entire complexity away from the application, and then you can really concentrate on creating the best features for your application. So if you are trying to create a social network which differentiates with Facebook in certain aspect, you can concentrate more on building those aspects as compared to providing your attention towards building REST APIs and managing the database. So this is what Firebase is trying to provide to the community. So let's get down to my laptop and then I will explain you what NoSQL databases are and how Firebase can actually help us in cutting down on the complexities at the backend and how our application can store and get the data from Firebase real-time database. So let's get started. All right, so let's talk about this NoSQL thing first. So if you have some working knowledge about relational database management system, those are also known as RDBMS database systems. So in those systems, we create tables, and in those tables, we store the data. As you can see here, let's suppose we are maintaining a database of our employees. So if we are talking about an RDBMS system, we will first create a table about employee, which is going to contain basic data about the employee. Then we are going to create yet another table, which is going to contain the salary data of our employees. So we can create several tables which contain several types of data for employees, right? So we can segregate data, or we can divide the data into tables. Now, to identify the record of one particular employee in all of those tables, we use concepts like
primary key and foreign key. So if you are talking about this employee table, this employee ID is a unique identifier for all of the employees. So you can identify an employee based on its employee ID, right? So employee ID serves as a primary key for this table. Now you can actually use this primary key to get the data, I mean the related data of that employee from other tables as well. So if you have noticed that this 123 ID is existing in this salary table as well, so this represents that this 5000 is the salary of my employee who is having an employee ID of 123. So this is how you create tables, and this is how you create a mapping between the data which resides over several tables. Okay, so this is a RDBMS system. Now this is pretty rigid system, you cannot change it. If you want to store one more column about an employee, you cannot do that. For that you have to create a new column into this table and then you can put in the data. But when you do that, you also have to ensure that at the end of the day you are not going to break your application which operates on the data, because if the application is expecting only three columns and you are going to provide it four columns, so there has to be some sort of mechanism in place which can handle that sort of scenarios. So RDBMS systems are very rigid when it comes to the structure of the data. Now let's talk about the NoSQL thing. So basically NoSQL is all about structuring your data in such a way that you can make changes to the structure of the database without breaking your application. So if we were to map our earlier RDBMS system into a NoSQL system, it would look like this. So here we have got this employees, and this employees structure, this is a simple JSON structure. So this employee structure contains this record 123, and this 123 is yet another structure which contains more fields about the information of an employee. And we have got this salaries structure as well, which contains the salary data of our employee. But this is a NoSQL representation of the same data. So here as you can see that there is one big JSON object which contains all of the data. So this is how you arrange data in NoSQL. But why would we store data in such a way? Because now let's suppose we want to also store the gender of an employee. We can readily insert one new entry inside this 123 field, and it can contain data like this, and at the end of the day it is not going to break our application which operates on this data. And since there are no database rules in place when it comes to NoSQL, the database is not going to report any error. So now I think you understand that when it comes to NoSQL database management, we can put in as many records as we would like into our data structure, because there are no rules to be followed when it comes to the types of data you can store. So this gender record can be present in some records, and this gender record can not be present in some records. So you can manage that sort of structure using NoSQL. Also one more advantage of using NoSQL thing is fast read, because as you can see that all of your data about this 123 employee resides in this one path, right? So you can readily read this 123 record and you are going to get all of the data. Now let's suppose you want to read the salary of an employee who is having an ID of 123. So you can readily read the record 123 and you are going to get the salary information of your employee. But in case of NoSQL, you can improve your speeds of getting the data. Now let's suppose you also want to get the name of the employee along with his salary, but in RDBMS system you have to resort to apply joins between the tables in order to get the data. So joins are comparatively slower, but in NoSQL you can actually improve the reading speed by duplicating some of your data. So you can create a structure like this. So we have duplicated this one particular record name inside our salaries structure. So this is our new record. Now if you are coming from an RDBMS background, you must be losing your mind. You would be thinking that we are duplicating our data, and of course we are duplicating our data, but now we don't really have to rely on joins, which are comparatively slower as compared to reading something readily from one path. So now I can readily get the name of an employee. I just have to ensure that I am storing the name of my employee along with his salary. So that is how NoSQL databases can ensure that the reads are really faster. But it has this one challenge, that suppose if your employee is going to change its name or something like that, then you'll have to ensure that the name gets changed in all of the related places. So if this name changes, you'll have to ensure that you change the name here as well. So but things like that happen less frequently as compared to reading the data about the salaries. So you optimize for reads and not for writes. So hence in NoSQL we can duplicate the data, and it is also known as denormalization in RDBMS system, and that is how you can readily access your data from anywhere. And that is how you can also ensure that the reads are really fast. Okay, so let's come to the Firebase real-time database. So it stores your data as a big JSON object. So this is one JSON object, and all of your data is going to be contained in a structure similar to this. So it is going to be stored as key value pair, and the key can contain values which are map or which are yet another JSON object in themselves. Okay, so now to read data you do something like this. So if we are talking about this 123 employee salary, so you readily read the data from this location. Okay, so slash salaries will go here and slash 123 will go to this place, and if you read from this location you are going to get this object of two properties, namely salary and name. Now if you want to read the salary only of your employee, you can read it from this location slash salaries slash 123 slash salaries. So that is how you read the data from the Firebase real-time system. Okay, so what do we mean by real time? So Firebase has this mechanism in place that whenever a data changes on the server, it can notify your client applications about the change of the data, based on which your client application can fetch the data from the server, the new data from the server, and then it can display the new data. So let's suppose you are talking about the salary updation part. So if you have a client application which is continuously listening to this one particular path on the Firebase database, and as soon as someone updates the salary of this employee, your application will get a notification from the Firebase database system that the data residing on this path has changed. So it has to fetch new data in order to show it to the user. So let's talk about a chat application. Let's suppose you have two members interacting with each other. So you can create a chat room which can be a URL like this, and then you can store all of those messages in that one chat room. So as soon as someone writes a new message, all of the client applications which are listening on that part will be notified that there is a new message which they can then fetch and display on user's screen. So that is how you can easily design a chat system using Firebase real-time database management system. Okay, so this is all about the theoretical part of Firebase. Now let's go to console.firebase.google.com in order to create a Firebase database for ourselves. You can click on this button to create a database. Let's suppose we want to create a message board where people can exchange messages with everyone, so that if someone posts something on a message board, it will be visible to everyone using the application. So this is going to be a really simple application, and I'm not going to build this application in this video. For this you will have to wait for some time, then I'll create a video which uses React Native as a front end, and then we will use this Firebase database as a back end for that application. Okay, so you can switch the country. Since I am from India, so I'm going to select India here. Okay, let me see why it is not detecting India. Okay, so here it is. Okay, and accept everything and create a new project. So it is going to take a while. Okay, let's go to this. Okay, so here is our database. Now we have got two type of databases in Firebase. The first one is the Firebase real-time database, and then we have got this Firebase Firestore. Okay, so we are not going to talk about this Firestore, and I will probably release a video about Firestore in near future, but for the time being we are going to stick to our real-time database. So there are two modes which allows you to actually control who is going to access the data from the database and what he or she can actually access from the database. So these are known as security rules, and which help you in controlling the access to the database. For now we are going to start in test mode. Okay, so as you can see that anyone with a database reference can actually read or write to your database. So as of now we can just go ahead with the test setting. Okay, so our database is word readable and writable. Okay, so here is our database. Now it is going to be a JSON structure. So as you can see here that this is the key and this is its value. Okay, so let's create a new property that is going to be messages. Okay, and then we are going to store our messages in this field. Okay, so let's create one more, and the message can be a structure like, so we have to assign some key, so it can be message, and the message can be Facebook privacy breach. Okay, so as you can see that now we have got this one particular JSON structure of our data. Now if I want to listen to the real-time changes on this path, so I can just go there, and this is the path which I can listen to. So if you are using Firebase SDK, this is the part of the path you have to attach your listener to. Now listener is a mechanism of listening to changes on this one particular path using Firebase SDK. Okay, so this is the data which will be returned to your application in case you choose to read this one particular path. So that is how you actually arrange the database in one giant JSON blob. Okay. So I think by now you might have got a little bit information about what Firebase is, what NoSQL is, and how you can actually create data in Firebase. In my next video, I'm going to show you how we can actually develop our real world message board application using React Native and Firebase. So make sure to subscribe to Rain Studio's YouTube channel in case you are interested in learning about these stuff. Take care. Bye-bye.